Heritage Stone Access has been running for approximately 10 years, working on various different historic projects, whether it be castles, churches, abbeys, cathedrals, or in this case, we had the privilege of working on the main tower at York Minster. What we're able to do is simply be literally the hands-on and the eyes for an architect and either take templates, take measurements, everything one could do off a scaffold, we're able to do off the ropes to eliminate the time that a scaffolding is up. So key measurements that we could give to a saw shop or a quarry so stones can get cut and worked before the scaffold even goes up is pretty much key with what we can do. So it's a really good way of working in junction with a scaffolding project, let's say, but all we're doing is eliminating the time that the scaffold's actually up on the structure. A lot of things can easily get overlooked, like there are no mechanical means to the top. You know, it really is a case of walking up the steps. What we're always able to do is use structural points of the church, i.e. big roof timbers, big roof beams, or even feed the rope back down to the ground and find a solid anchor point on the floor, whether that be a stone pillar. So not necessarily is always the anchor point above us.
And because of that, because you're using the anchor points in these historic ancient buildings, you need to have an in-depth knowledge of the structure and the architecture of the building in order to be completely aware of exactly what kind of load these buildings can take.
It's a really well thought out process. It may look sort of we're throwing ropes down and it's dangerous, but the main objective really is to eliminate any risk on a structure, whether that's from falling stone or anything's become dislodged, or whether it's part of a process of a larger conservation or restoration project where we're able to sort of get into a location which has been well thought out and take what's termed as templates and various measurements with the stone, which is what one would do off a scaffold. And the same person taking those templates and measurements will be the same person working the stone. Thank you. So it's not only the risk to one's safety which gets eliminated, but also the risk to the building. So the ropes won't flap around and potentially break the stained glass windows. You know, we don't want to create any more damage to the building. The main thing is obviously safety is paramount. So everything gets adjusted around the safety aspect. So every tool, every trowel, everything is lanyarded off to us, so nothing can be dropped. Almost rehearsed the fact that whoever's working with each other, there's that same sort of relationship as one would have in a climbing situation. So you're constantly looking out for each other. Not only equipment-wise, but you're looking at where other people's ropes are. You're double-checking anchor points, you're double-checking rope protection. And this is almost happens in subconscious. This is almost, you know, it becomes second nature to us now. And it's a lot like the sort of relationship you'd have in a difficult climbing situation. What I think, you know, what we're able to do off the ropes is conservation, restoration projects, whether that be defrassing, pointing up, maybe even, well, the main aim really is to slow down the weathering process.
All of this knowledge and experience has led us to be where we are today.